On these streets, social distancing rules had been relaxed and most businesses had reopened. But all that changed after a six-day national holiday in South Korea at the end of April. Today, the country is bracing for a second wave of infections. This after new spikes in coronavirus cases linked to Seoul's nightlife, including several gay clubs, which now threaten the densely populated capital. And authorities are scrambling to track and test more than 5,500 people who visited those establishments, but more than half remain out of reach.
연락이 닿지 않는 1,982명에 대해서는 기지국 정보, 클럽 카드 결제 정보 등을 통해 확인을 하고 있습니다. 또한 용산 경찰서에서도 추후 역학 조사가 충분히 이루어질 수 있도록 CCTV 자료를 확보하였습니다.
One of the main challenges this time around, those being tested want to remain anonymous due to the stigma surrounding homosexuality in the socially conservative country. Meanwhile, President Moon Jae-in earlier this Tuesday reinforced the need to practice some form of quarantine.
눈앞의 위기를 보면서 머뭇거릴 여유가 없습니다. 방역 보건 체계부터 시급히 강화해야 합니다.
Now, while South Korea had been hailed as a global model in how to curb COVID-19, it has now become the poster child for the risks of reopening a country.